In movies, hacking is all finesse, excitement, and genius coding. But in reality, it's angel-headed hipsters burning for the ancient heavenly connection to the starry dynamo and the machinery of night. Ginsburg. Hey there, Zero Cools, Neos, and C-Tech astronomers, I'm Trace. Thanks for tuning in for some D-News. Passwords are like apples in a fictional garden. They're perfect, ripe, and there for the taking, if you know how. Websites have a lot of different ways to store passwords: hashing, salting, tokens, two-factor authentication. We have a whole video about it. But hacking a password? That's a lot more fun, right? So first, for noobs, passwords aren't stored as words, but as a set of encrypted characters called hashes. They look like this. If you want to access your account, you don't really need your password. I just have to find the thing that lets me decrypt that hash, or at least match it. To do that, hacker communities created something called lookup tables and rainbow tables, data files of common passwords that are pre-hashed. Password 123 hashed is this. ABCDE 12345 hashed is this. If a hacker did this beforehand and has millions of passwords, they can just compare them and then get access to your account. And hackers can do this comparison really fast. In a test for Ars Technica, a computer could try 350 billion combinations every second. 350 billion password guesses every second. How common does your password feel now? But companies have a weapon against rainbow tables. It's called salt. Not like literal salt. It's basically taking random chunks of code and tossing them into that hash password. As our AP Donna says, it changes the flavor. If salted hashes are found, the rainbow tables are useless because they're never going to find a match. Computers aren't great at problem solving, so even this little change can fumble automated hacking programs. Without the tables, everything takes longer. Hackers have to find out how that salt was added. The beginning of each password? After the 15th character? Is it different for every user? Then they have to figure out what the salt characters are. One encoder, bcrypt, puts $2a at the beginning of every hash. But usually, salted passwords are enough to stop a lot of hackers because it's faster to change tack and use dictionary attacks or brute force attacks. These were made famous in shows like Mr. Robot. Dictionary attacks use word lists to take common passwords like password 123 and just try them out. They salt and hash them on the fly and compare them to passwords in the database at the speed of light. Brute force attacks are even more crazy. They start with, say, AAAA, salt and hash it in various ways and then compare those to the database. Then they try AAAB, then AAAC, you get it. They just take every possible combination and it takes forever. When it comes to simple text, computers are wicked fast. A hacker doing a test for Ars Technica cracked over 10,000 passwords in 16 minutes just trying combinations at random within the password specifications, less than 8 characters, capital letter, lowercase letter, etc. Hackers are in a constant race against time, not necessarily because the feds are right over their shoulder, like in the movies, but because once a company or agency or person realizes they've been hacked, they usually adjust their security, they go public, or they change their password, which is why hackers just hack you. If you are on an open Wi-Fi network without a password, you're basically shouting your passwords for anyone listening to hear. Some hackers will set up fake free Wi-Fi points to get common passwords and email addresses. Still others, they'll just use spam. If you click on a Word document or a link in an email, it can execute code on your computer called malware to copy everything you type, including passwords, credit card numbers, and whatever. And they can send that directly to the hacker. And still others pose as Facebook security or as a representative of your bank or as the IT department. Some will even call you on the phone. Never, ever give someone your password. Ever. If they are the company, they already have it. Why spend all that time hacking into a server if I can just trick you into telling me your password? Moral of the story, other than hacking is crazy interesting, is to use long, complicated passwords and never use the same one twice. Long passwords are harder for dictionary and word list-based attacks to solve quickly. It's actually less important to use passwords where letters are numbers, but instead use a long set of words like correct horse battery staple or song lyrics. Easy to remember, but so long it could take hacking programs years of computing time to guess them. It's sort of like that old joke about running from a bear. You don't have to be the fastest, you just don't want to be the slowest. If you haven't checked out the other video we just did about hacking and passwords, do that right here. And let us know down in the comments if you just changed your password, because I know I did after this. Thanks for tuning into D News. Please subscribe and come back soon.